for them. And so that was the big difference for us. I thought our guys really did a great job against a really dominant force. And that's where I felt like, you know, that was the key for us.
Coach, sort of history at stake, winning three titles in a row. Did you guys seem to play loose? Is that just not part of the equation for you?
Never talked about it. I mean, I addressed it once and just said to the guys, like, the only way, look, the Calvert Hall's won three in a row. But it's a program, and the 17 guys aren't here, the 18 players aren't here. This is a brand new team. So we have a lot of guys that were never a part of that. But look, it's a great honor. We never talk about outcomes. We just talk about just doing your job and focus on the process and just play and have fun and play with joy.
But how do you do that? How do you keep them so grounded? You know, I mean, all the distractions, social media, rankings, to keep them so focused?
I shared with them the other day, a parable I talked about when Jesus was walking on water and the storm and the rain coming down, and Peter asked, if, hey, can I walk on water and the storm? And he said, yes. And Peter said, walked on water. And when he was looking at Jesus Christ, he walked on water. But when he started focusing on the storms and all that stuff, he sunk. So if you start focusing on what people say, how good we are, how great we are, you're going to sink. If you start focusing on what people say negatives about us that aren't true, you're going to sink. Just focus on doing your job and having fun and just playing lacrosse, and you'll stay on the water and you'll stay. And that was it.
Yeah, talk to me a little bit about the continuity. I know they're different teams every year, but to be able to have a program win three straight with new guys coming in.
I think a lot of it happens from our 2016 team that lost. They were phenomenal leaders, and we lost in the quarterfinals that year. And I think they laid the foundation of a lot. But guys prior to that, but no one cares who scores. Like last night, Daniel had 7 points. I don't know what he did today, but I think Herbert was dominant. I don't know, you know, so someone different. Or Grant one day, the other day it was Connor, you know, who had 3 goals against Loyola. So no one really cares, or a Sauce or whoever. We just want to be one team, and we play as a team. And Coach Huntley always said the number one quality we look for in a player, are they a good teammate? And that's what these guys are. They're just good teammates. They care about each other.
Coach, 2 more questions.
Yep, thank you.
Talk about last year. You guys were motivated, you know, losing Huntley and then losing Arnardo late in the season. That was kind of the win to this last year's championship. What was the win to this year's team?
That's a great question. They just had fun and played, you know, and they just played for one another, and that was it, you know. I think last year it was a lot, it was heavy. This year there was like, you know, and it was an incredible for us to do what we did last year with all that adversity. And I think if, you know, and this year I just felt like these guys understood there's things bigger than lacrosse. And when you know that this is a game, it doesn't define who you are as a person. It's just is a game. It does, if you think you're special because you're a good lacrosse player, then you're in trouble. So these guys don't worry about that. They just play. And they just played for one another, and they were great teammates that just cared about being the best that they could be.
I don't know if I asked you this. You've been around this league for nearly 4 decades. Where does this team rank?
Sorry.
Among the best teams of all time.
You know, I leave that up for you guys. I mean, there's so many great teams, but...
Can I say it?
I have to say...
You're at the table, though.
I will say this, and I really don't, but I can't imagine a team as good as we are right now. Right. And, you know, that's how I feel. But
can you play Culver on Tuesday? I'll set it up. No?
No, you know what? I got my son's MLC 7-year-old lacrosse game.
the biggest game.
You know, that's tough. Didn't Culver lose to McDonough? I'm just kidding.
Congratulations, Brian.